Okay, here's our question of the day. Ask Dr. Rajani.
Hi, Dr. Rajani. I absolutely love your channel and I watch every single video. Yeah. My problem is that I am a super all natural person. I am hesitant to even take a Tylenol. So some of the treatments kind of scare me. I'd like to know what you would recommend for somebody like me, a really all natural person that's interested in some anti-aging stuff and, you know, some more aggressive treatments, but I don't want to put anything into my body, you know, that isn't natural. I'm pretty intense about that. So let me know what you think.
Okay, great. Why would you put things in your body that you don't have to? 95% of the market, the aesthetic market, wants all natural. Only 5% of the general population wants something put in their face. You walk down the street, most people say, yeah, I'm not doing that. That's crazy. Not using Botox, not doing fillers, not doing biostimulators. You now have a choice. And that's the beautiful part. Of course, things are going towards all natural. There are people that can't have things put in their body because of autoimmune disorders, etc., or they just don't want it. She wondered about all natural. Yes, you draw your blood, you spin it down. You concentrate your growth factors and stem cells. You can then heat it, get a gel component of the albumin that sits in your blood, put your growth factors, stem cells back, inject it back as a gel, or you can use the liquid form. There's two ways to do it and your practitioner will decide, but this all exists now. Now, PRP does have some unnatural things in it. By nature, it has blood thinners, sodium citrate, heparin, easy gel or platelet rich fiber, whatever you're using. If it's real PRP, it will not have additives. So what are some total options other than what she mentioned? And I'll put a link below. You can watch me get the easy gel so you see what that process is all about. For injectors, I have a whole free course on it. But all natural things, diet, meaning not lose your weight diet, unless you need to, but diet meaning what you eat. And watch my video on 8 superfoods. Exercise, so keeping a good body mass index, is absolutely key. Prevention of getting too much sun on your skin. I'm not talking about vitamin D deficiency, but wearing sunscreen when you're in the sun prolonged will save your collagen and elastin. Then you go to supplements. I'm a big fan. A lot of people aren't eating well enough to get enough nutrients. What do I take? Personally, just so you know what I do, I take turmeric, I take vitamin K2D3, I take collagen powder, I take fermented garlic, and I take krill oil. And then I try and eat as healthy as I can. Of course, I travel a lot. I don't eat healthy all the time. I slip, but that's okay. You do the best you can. Try and stay in shape and do things. Facial exercises, all natural. You on this channel love them. So I want you to comment below, educator on facial exercises. Those are all natural things. Now let's step it up, because that's not going to do it for most people forever. You get sag, you're going to lose some collagen, you're going to lose elastin, you might go through a period of time where you're not as well as another time, and you might be on certain meds that make you age quicker. You may lose hormones, okay? So then you go to, all natural would be, radio frequency. Watch my videos on RF, fractionated RF, Viora's VFR. Even for things like plump RF, I have videos. You can plump your lips with energy. That's natural in a sense, not putting anything into your body. The next stage up from that, yes, you go to injectables. At a certain point, if you want to stay looking youthful, some type of injectable will be necessary, quote unquote, to get the result that you would like for most people. And that would be that platelet-rich fiber. Those are your all natural options. And of course, skincare plays an absolute key role. I mentioned sunscreen, but what about alpha hydroxy acids? I'm a big fan of those. Vitamin C serum, hyaluronic acid serum, love that. And for lips are big and they balance the face. You want a little plumping, you want a little retinol for the lip, you want a little stimulation, peptides, which are signals for youth. I have a lip plumper. So those are things. You have your own favorite products. Certainly the comments below are where you're going to learn a lot. I should add to my supplements, I do use collagen powder. I think it works. If you watch my collagen powder videos, collagen supplement videos. Look at the comments below. Hair, skin, nails. For me, the biggest place I notice collagen powder is my joints, my feeling of well-being, of my mobility, able to play sports. When I come off it, I notice that. But certainly, hair would be next. I have no idea about nails, you just cut them. But I do, skin would be, you know, third on that list that I notice. But look in the comments on the collagen powder, everyone's a little different. That's all natural. You now have great choices. Take advantage of them. Stay tuned. Ask me below. There's a link. Ask Dr. Rajani in more info below this video. Stay healthy, beautiful, vibrant.